Hello everybody and welcome back to another Roblox Studio dev stream. In this video we're just doing maintenance. I've added in a lot of these buildings and I realized that most of the interactables you have to click on. And I suspect that maybe some of the other players, they're overlooking that, right? So what we're doing is we're just adding proximity prompts and we're just replacing this, updating the code. Just like that. I think everything else has been converted. Oh, these buttons here too. Right. Oh, and then what I have to do is edit the proximity. Yeah, these next couple of videos, this is all this is gonna be. We're gonna go over, we're gonna convert all these things to prompts. And then what we're going to do is, now this I'm gonna have to test. Yeah, let me test some of this first. Then we'll finish going over the vehicles again because we have the two tow trucks and the crane to change, and then we have the boom truck with the bucket on it. I'm sure a lot of people are gonna wanna. I don't know if I converted that, but anyways, that's basically what we're gonna do, and that should be it for vehicles. Right, so once all the prompts are caught up, and then the vehicles are caught up, I can work on some more infrastructure, and I can work on adding some additional vehicles. Give players just some more options, right? Now this here, the keyboard code, I think if I change that to be, instead of when you look at the prompt and it says E, it'll just say B instead. So this will be left. I'm not gonna get too carried away into that. Really? My mouse. Oh man, seriously. My mouse is dying. All right. All right. Yeah, because I realized I added all this stuff, and then... No, don't do that. Insert option. What is going on here? Ugh, all right. It works there. Yeah. I think that'll do for this one. And all the quests. Right? And then that should say... Lift. Yeah, because I noticed with the controller, it's R2 is the mouse button, but you have to be like really focused, right? So if I make these buttons a little too small, you know, they may not pop up. I know there's still an issue with the UIs being the names have changed. So after I'm done converting all the trucks, I'll make sure that all that as well is worked out. Try and make sure. And so what I'm doing is I'm adding a weight. All right, to the beginning. That's really important. This game was really starting to slow down because all these scripts were loading. They were just loading. So what I found was if I went through and I asked a lot of this stuff to wait before it loads, it actually really helped my game perform a lot better. So I just never finished, I guess, going through. And that's part of what we're doing now. This is what I did in Blue Truck as well. I think I went through like Blue Truck and City. I went through like almost 8,000 scripts. Really improved the game. This is just for this year. And when you back into it, you make contact with it on the trailers. Makes the door go invisible. I was going to have, if you guys have ever played Delivery Industry, that's a fun game. It's a big game. And you know how you back into the door, and then the window comes up, and then you pay that way, right? You get your money. Well, wanted to do something similar. You can't go inside these bays. I think eventually I was going to make it so you could walk inside the bay and unload your trucks. I might do that. We'll see. Okay, so that's that. I wonder if I adjusted these as well. Let's see here. Yeah, and eventually we're going to hook up these pump handles. We're going to have fuel. Oh, I got this terminal here too. Yeah, we'll have fuel that you'll need to put into the trucks. It'll be cool, and I'll make a little bar and stuff. Hopefully it goes all right. I don't add too much to the game. Press play before we continue just to see if I messed anything up. Alright, we're working our way over to the side of the map. So let's see. That's cool. I didn't even realize the sign. I put these open signs in and they flash. That's cool. Like O, B. E-E-N. Ah, that's deep. Is it even a button? Oh, interesting. Oh yeah, this little button here. Okay, well I guess I'll have to go back. I forgot all about that. I'll have to go back to here. To this one. All right, now we're gonna have to test this. The first open sign seems gonna work. I'll have to add this sign to the other shops too. Forgot all about that. Sign's not working. Alright, so I'll have to edit the script a little bit more. So confusing. We're just gonna simplify this. Holy moly. Alright, and then we just need to say. Scripts. Where's the? Oh, there is no value. Dot parent. Dot parent. Dot open scripts. Dot enabled equals true. this. Well, true. Oh, I see what they did here. So we'll have to change this here. It constantly rolls through. So what we need to do is we need to insert an object. And we need to set a bool value. All right. And we just need to rename this to on. Oh, please go back to where you were. Rename that to on. All right. And we can say script.parent.parent. Say if on. Oh, no, we'll have to local that here. On equals script dot parent dot on dot value. If on equals true, then. On is equal to true, then let's see. Nope. Do we need to put another? That's the close script. So it'll just cycle. All right, well, I'm going to have to change that. We're going to have to change that. I didn't realize this sign is kind of broken here. Get rid of that. Yeah, it's kind of broken in the, okay, so let's see here. Let's see, scripts. Parent dot bottom line, and then we'll say script dot parent dot parent dot o. Open sign back. Do we need the bottom line? I don't think we do, honestly. Let's take a look at the sign. Oh yeah, we do need that. Okay. That's the blue line. Alright. Let's see. Copy. P E N. And then that'll be the top line. Oh. P. And there we go. I guess it was kind of cool because they sort of had, we can do this, we'll see, so let's take this, and let's see, wait, one, you know what, that doesn't even matter, actually, it'll just turn on, the sign will turn on, I'm just wondering if I wanted to scroll OPEN, you know, over and over again. I won't worry about it. All right. So we'll say click equals true. So something like that could have been a major point of lag on the map too. Food for thought. It's neat the way they had it done up. Let's see here. Oh, looks like I can fix all of them right from here. Cool. Okay, so we deleted that. We deleted that, and then we got rid of the sounds. We're going to replace those with a different sound, and that basically just got rid of all the scripts. Turn it into our own. Yeah, so at this point in time, really, this is kind of, if you're having issues, the game is really struggling, that's when it's time to go through your scripts. Edit them, add latency, do whatever you can to try and slow down the loading time of the scripts, because that can also be an issue. If too many scripts are trying to load, one pain. Don't think I have to make that local script. Wait. All right. Now we are over here. So we fixed that. Did we do the register? No, we did not. This will be checkout. We'll just say that. And then I'll be B, and then requires line of sight. Now, my theory behind this is, if all the information is server-side, if you tell the script to wait, rather than load, try and load right away. If the client comes near this script, play it here. Maybe it won't load if you lag or whatever. I don't know. It seems to make improvements, though. I can guarantee you that. Before I started doing that, it took about 45 seconds for Blue Truck to save. And after just adding that latency, I got it down to like 7 seconds. It can save the game. So, okay, perfect. We didn't get... didn't get any errors that time. All right. Now, we don't have... this one's going to be kind of tricky. Eventually, I'd like to add a heater in here, too. I don't want to tackle the DLT just yet, because we're going to add some more missions. When I add more missions, that's when we're going to go over the DLT. So when we're done converting the trucks is when we're going to add more missions, and I'll add more vehicles. Make sure I have carpet in all the places. Yeah, I haven't edited all of them. Let's see. So. Some of them are going to be blank. They'll just say interact. Let's see, let's backtrack just a little bit and let's go over to the burger joint. Let's see, this was proximity prompt. Let's just add a value to that. These are prompts, these are prompts. Inside here, oh, the register. come in is going to be button B. Like I say, once I've added all the prompts, it'll be a lot easier to go through. Sometimes you have to be careful. If the prompt is hidden deep inside an object, if you tell that it requires line of sight and it's within another part, you won't be able to see it. The player won't be able to see it. So just be aware of that. Set a few different things. There's this one I don't know if we'll do it for the fridge, too. The doors. Yeah, why not? All right. I think that'll do it for the burger joint. I will just press play. Just in case I made a mistake in any of those scripts that I edited, it'll tell me. Oh, yeah. One. Come on, mouse, come on. Really? Thank you. It's a dollar store, mouse. It was $4. But I got like almost 2 years out of it. Which is not bad for a $4 mouse. Bought it because I only have a cordless mouse, and sometimes if I'm doing lots of programming, the processor will delay the mouse. It'll start skipping and tracing across and won't register clicks. So I was in a hurry and I needed a mouse, so I went to the dollar store. I don't know what they are now. They're probably $5 now. Everything at the dollar store is minimum $5 now. Everything, the prices have doubled. All right. What can you do? Okay, now we got this here. I already switched over the uniforms inside. All right. Right now, it's a lot easier during the testing phase to make all this stuff. So it's click of a mouse button. Now that's just because the proximity prompts. It takes a minute. I always forget. This should be like that. Let's do a test, shall we? Yeah, I'll add a more dynamic firefighting system just to give a little more excitement. Like, I don't want this to be, I said that once and I'll say it again, I don't want this to be an emergency response type game. What's going on here? So yes, it requires line of sight, and you notice how there's a mesh there. I don't think that could be. Let's find out right now. I think the proximity prompt might have been hidden by the mesh. Got a little more horsepower. Yeah, I don't know why it's not showing up. Let's say let's do that. This one's right last night. Let's just see what's going on. That's exactly it. So if we come around to here, see, I said requires line of sight, and then it can't see this button here. All right. So that's something to be kind of got to watch out for. We'll have to go back through and check now. All right. Yeah, the last area now will be Zoom. So let's just, I'll just go through real quick and just make sure that I haven't missed too many. See how the open sign looks. Check out the store first. So, the cash register, no, can't see the cash register. Turn open sign on. Turn the heat on, can't see the register. Okay, so I'll have to go through the registers again. Hey, that open sign looks pretty good. Couple of windows are still foggy. That's so funny. Okay, so the register. I better check the burger restaurant then, just to make sure. It's just a matter of turning them from requires line of sight to not require line of sight. And then you'll be able to see them, you know. Like I say, if they're buried, if they're inside an object, within an object. Oh yeah, okay, that one works. So it might just be the stores. That one doesn't work. Okay. Oh, we have the fridge in the fire department to do too. That's right. Okay, so we need to go to the stores. And tick that off. And then no, this one worked. It was the checkout. Out of the store, right? All right, that one should be okay. Let's check this one here. That one should be okay. All right, so maybe we'll get lucky on this one. All right, so we'll go to the fire hall. Oh, that's right. We got the heaters inside here. That too. Okay. Yeah. So let's insert object. Proximity prompt. So if you say requires line of sight, you won't be able to see the proximity prompt through the walls either. So it's very, very, very situational, whatever your game type is. All right, just like that. And then I think we have the one of these. Is it that one there? It is. Let's say insert object. Now that one, this one's gonna be a little difficult because I'll have to say requires line of sight. This is like soda. Try that anyhow. See how that works. Because you'll be able to see it through the fridge door. Whatever. I'll figure it out. Okay, that's that. I guess there's no light in here. That's that. All right, now the final sort of area. I went through. Those are on touch. This one should be okay with requires. Yeah, we'll do that. I was gonna say it should be okay because the button isn't inside and then you just never know. Yeah, I was trying to change it to button B because we have all these hotkeys, right? And if you're in your vehicle, B is going to be kind of like the universal, isn't going to despawn your vehicle or do anything. B is the button you can press on the console and everything will be just fine. That's the idea. But if you're not inside your vehicle, it actually shouldn't matter. Just as long as it's not Y, then it's gonna tell you, ask you to donate every time you try and activate a prompt. That's not fair. Now this is gonna have to be like this. I suppose if I think it works either way. I'll have to double check here. Do some testing. I'll have to do that later. Alright, insert object. What's this one? I'm actually going to leave this one, and I am going to see. I'm going to come back here. Let's see. It should work both ways, I think. Sure. All right, how are we doing for time? Whew. 1 hour of working with proximity prompts. Exciting. All right, let's see. Let's see what we've done here. No errors. I like that. I like that. That works. Won't turn off that way. Okay. One of these I fixed. It's just we tested out here. One of these I fixed. Alright, so I guess that's the difference between else space if and else if. Else if it will turn off. Else if it will turn off. Nope, I didn't fix that one either. One of these I fixed, I was pretty sure. Oh, it waits. Ah, that's right. It scrolls through the cycle and then it turns off. So maybe it is working. Oh well, we have to wait for it to go through the whole cycle here. Now that it's on. No, something's definitely. Just the one. Oh yeah, that one there, see? This one did work. Yeah, this one here did work. It turned on. So it rolls through its cycle. heated booth. Turn it off. Don't know what the delay is. Maybe we'll change the delay. Oh yeah, see it's flickering there. Then it goes yellow. It turns off. Hey, right on. Well, thank you so much for watching. This just a maintenance video. The next couple are probably going to be like this. We will get into the vehicles very, very soon. We'll finish the vehicles very, very soon. Thank you very much and have a wonderful night.